Hey guys, Razorblade Mango here, and today I wanted to talk about a subject that I don't often touch on the channel, and it's kind of been going around in my head the last few days, and that would be the release of an album, and in this case it is the, you know, now cultural icon Kendrick Lamar's latest release, Mr. Morale and the Big Steppers, which dropped at the time of recording this last night. But I mainly want to talk about the lead up to this album and how I think video game companies should take a lesson from it. Because Kendrick Lamar and how he handled the marketing build up release of this album, I thought was nothing short of masterfully done. It is one of the most efficient album releases. It's one of the most efficient releases I've ever seen. And it's definitely the best one I've seen in a long time, especially in the wake of Bethesda delaying Starfield and Redfall out of 2023. I feel like video game companies could learn a lot from how Kendrick Lamar dropped his latest album. So to start, Kendrick Lamar announced the album, not exactly with a title or a release date, but he talked about the general idea of where his head was back in August of last year. And again, it didn't provide anything concrete. It was just kind of like, hey, I'm going over the album. This is where my head's at this point, and it will be, he confirmed that it will be his final release under Top Dog Entertainment. That was all it was, and it was enough to kind of be like, okay, fair enough, take all the time you need, cool. We didn't get another update until April 18th, where he announced in a post on his website, very similar to how Michael very clearly imitating how Michael Jordan announced his comeback all those years ago. And he just said, here's the album title, here's the release date, thank you for your patience, see you later. And I felt like that was both, he found that sweet spot between making us wait a while for it and feeling like, oh crap, it's right around the corner. He found that sweet spot where he was able to extend the hype even further, get people talking about it, and it wasn't annoying because we didn't have to wait very long for it, which I think is great, especially in an era where video game companies like Bethesda announce release dates literally a year, almost a year and a half in advance, and then they end up delaying it, which to me, I understand why they want to delay Starfield, because they don't want another Cyberpunk on their hands, but it's just like, it's like, why even announce this game? Why even announce this release date? Just do it when you know you got this shit in the bag. And I feel like video game companies could learn a lot from Kendrick Lamar in that way, where they just shut up, they don't talk about their stuff for a long while, a lot through production, even if it leaks, just don't talk about it. Don't say anything. Don't comment on rumor or speculation. Very simple. And then when the game is maybe 6 months out, announce it, date, boom. And you know who got this right? Ironically, it was Bethesda themselves with Fallout 4 all those years ago, back in 2015. They didn't talk about it, they didn't publicly acknowledge it, even though we knew it had been leaked to death. We knew so much about the game before it was even officially announced. But back in May 2015, they just said, hey, here's the title, trailer, see you at E3. And then at E3, they went on like a deep dive about it. Here's the date. See you later. And it launched in November of 2015, just like they said it would. Again, efficient, open, honest, masterfully done. Regardless of how you feel about Fallout 4 as a game, but as far as announcing it, marketing it, releasing it, it was perfectly done, just from a marketing standpoint, efficiency standpoint. Similar to how Kendrick Lamar did his latest album. And then you move on to earlier this week on Sunday, where he dropped his promotional single for it, which is The Heart Part 5, which is a great song, great music video. Fucking hype went through the roof for this thing, and it got people talking. And again, he didn't have to go on any press tours, he didn't have to do a bunch of singles and songs and all this stuff. It was just, all he did was just a sheet of paper on his website announcing the date, title, and then single, music video. That's about as lean as you can get. That's like the second most like efficient way you could handle dropping an album and having it be successful. Similar to how, not similar, but the next logical step, the most extreme you could do is like what Led Zeppelin did with 4, where they didn't even say they were Led Zeppelin and they just dropped it. And it was like, holy shit. It was just like a big thing back then. And then again, Kendrick Lamar, he never once delayed it. He never fucked around with fans. He just said, hey, here's the album. It's dropping on this date. And he dropped it. He dropped it at almost literally on the dot at 9 p.m. Pacific time, May 13th at midnight Eastern time. And it was out. Everyone could enjoy it. There weren't any last minute delays, no fuckery, no nothing. It was just there. And that to me is excellent because it proved Kendrick Lamar could both be an efficient marketer and he could hit deliverables. And he has enough respect for his audience and his fans to go, I am not going to drop this. I'm not going to tell you all about it until I am 100% sure it is in the bag. It is ready to go. And I think that is extremely commendable. And I think video game companies should look at how Kendrick Lamar dropped this album and marketed it and released it and have that be, this should be like a Bible on how to do it. Don't announce your games fucking years in advance with short little teaser trailers or CGI bullshit. Don't give dates that you know you can't hit. Don't give years that you know you can't hit. I'm fucking looking at you, God of War Ragnarok. And just announce the shit when it's like 6 months out and you're done. That's it. I feel like more video game companies should do that. I feel like we would have somewhat more trust in them if they did that. We wouldn't be as like disappointed by these delays. We wouldn't be as skeptical when they announce dates for games. And I understand, video games and albums are two completely different beasts. I get it. I understand it. But I feel like as far as marketing and public information, they really should become more efficient and they should take lessons on how Kendrick Lamar did this, because I think how Kendrick Lamar did it was nothing short of excellent and respectful and lean, and I love that. Anyway, thank you so much for watching. If you like what you see, subscribe. Let me know what you guys think of how Kendrick Lamar dropped his latest album, the album itself. As always, I am Razorblade Mango. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll catch you all later. Bye.